Hey there, friends. I'm Dominique from the Pixie Planner. Welcome back to my channel. Today, I'm going to be taking you through the setup of my home management binder. This is something I've been thinking about for the past few weeks because I've come to realize that it's just been too overwhelming for me to keep all of my home information, like the car maintenance, any repairs or projects, pet medication and records. It was too much to keep it all in one planner. And so I decided, you know what? I'm just gonna make a binder with all of that information, everything pertaining to home, medical, auto, all of that good stuff is gonna be in one place now. So I have decided to set that up in my big happy planner, and I absolutely love how this has turned out. So I came across a ton of free printables online, and I'm gonna share those with you down below. And yeah, why don't we just go ahead and get started, and I'm gonna show you how I set this up. Okay, friends, so here it is. I have my dividers already good to go. And let me just run through here what I have. So my first section is going to be my calendar, since that's what I'm going to be referencing kind of most often. Finances will be second, health and medical will be third. And this is going to include not only my stuff and my husband's, but also our dog Maggie will go in that same section. And then we have cleaning, home maintenance, which is going to be, of course, anything we have done inside the home, but also outside the home too. And that would include our cars. And then we go into projects, miscellaneous, and notes. So notes, obviously, that's just going to be scrap piece of paper that I can just grab from and jot down stuff. Miscellaneous, I'm still tweaking that a little bit. I think what I'm going to do is keep like books read, movies watched, kind of that type of deal in that section. So I have my big happy planner that I'm going to set up, and you can see the dividers here are also from the happy planner line. And I love that these are going to add a little bit of fun to the binder. So let me put those aside. Then next we get into my pile of printables. Now I did a lot of research online to kind of see what I wanted to try out. I didn't want to go and purchase anything just yet because I'm still tweaking the system. I don't know if it's going to stay, you know, exactly this. So I found a bunch of blogs that have free printables, and I will leave that information down below for you. And I'm super, super happy with it so far. So in my first section, this will be my calendar section. I did have to redate the first month. You could see here, it says, let me turn that for you. It says January 18th. She will be having a 2019 calendar printable soon, but I was impatient, couldn't wait. So all I'm going to end up doing is white out for 2018. And you could see I already redated that. I did not do the rest of it, so that's what I will end up doing after this video. And then each of the sections I have to match the order of my dividers. So I am just going to go ahead and set it up, and then I will take you through each one section by section and talk a little bit more about it. Thank you. Okay, so got her all set up. I did have to cut a little bit out when I was doing our health and medical section, of course, privacy reasons. But let me go ahead and take you through a quick flip through of this now. So I am going to keep this pocket folder in the front, and what I'll end up doing is this will be kind of like a file system when I get a bill, or you know, maybe I'll do bills on one side, receipts on the other, that need to be kind of filed within. So I have this in the very front. Then I go straight into my calendar, okay? And what I'm gonna do with this first page, as you can see, says dates to remember. So I'm gonna write in birthdays, anniversaries, weddings, big events, things like that. So that way I can see it all at a glance. Now for the paper that I printed on 32 pound paper. I really enjoy the thickness and the feel of 32 pound. It doesn't, you know, bleed through with the majority of my pens. So I did go ahead and use nicer quality paper for this binder, even though, you know, the whole point of me putting this binder together was not only because I was tired of carrying everything with me in my one planner or my everyday carry, but I also didn't want this to be too pretty. I am the type of person that I'm very indecisive. I like a lot, and when I make something too pretty, I change my mind very quickly. I find that when it's just simple, I'm okay with simple. I just stick with it, and my brain tells me, okay, it's just simple. There's nothing more you can do with it. But if I try to make it all colorful and pretty, and then I'm like, well, wait a minute, this could be better. So let me try this. So I don't want this to be labor. I want this to be something that I open up every day, or even I'll probably just keep this binder open in my kitchen area. That way my husband can come and look at it whenever he needs to. I can glance at it. It's just, it's gonna be a workhorse. Nothing fancy or frilly about it. And I'm super excited for that. So after that page here of dates to remember, which the majority of my printables are from, I think you pronounce it HoosierHomemade.com. I will leave the information down below. But all of my calendar pages are from her blog, and I do like that they are on one page because I just want to have a quick, you know, glance at what's going on each month. I don't need too big of a space. It's just my husband, myself. We don't have kids, so our calendar doesn't usually look super crazy. I will print out when she comes out with the January or the year 2019. I will print that out because the date dots do take up a lot of the space in the boxes. So I'll go ahead and reprint those probably. But for now, I really like the month on one page, and I like that I can have this folded in half in the kitchen and it's not taking up a massive amount of space. I was gonna use a three-ring binder for this system, but that was my one thing where I was like, I don't want it like open wide the whole entire time. I want it to be able to fold it in half just like that, so it barely takes up any space. So we can have our calendar at a glance whenever needed. So that is all of the 12 months that I have printed up. Then we go into my finance section. Now my finance section is going to be my budgeting, my sinking funds that I'm gonna try to get into this year. I have not done sinking funds. I've read a lot about it. I've heard a lot about it, and I want to go for it. I really, really need to get my budgeting in order this next year. So the finance section will be very detailed. In my planner, I will keep track of my spending, my expenses. So I'll make sure that every day I write out in my, you know, daily planner how much I spent that day. And then probably at the end of the week, I will come into this binder and fill it in with that information. So that way I'm keeping up with this, but I'm also checking in on my budget weekly. So I printed this up from thebudgetmom.com. I just discovered her, and she has some amazing tips and tricks for budgeting, especially if you're a newbie like myself. So I printed up this kind of, you know, mini workbook that she has here, and I'm super excited to get started with this. The whole month of December, what I've been doing is just keeping track of my expenses. I have not done any budgeting, you know, like this, just to see where my money is going. I'm keeping track of all of it. Then in January, I will have a much better idea of what I can, you know, start doing for my budget. So I like that these are undated. You can reprint as many as you want. My printer is acting up. I think it's running out of ink, so yours would not have these lines that you'll see a little bit of as I go through some pages. It's just my ink. But I love the layout of this. And then we have here a monthly spending, so I can go ahead and, you know, fill that out as like a your traditional calendar and write in each day. So again, I have it at a glance. I'm a very visual person, and I really appreciate multiple layouts of visualizing your spending. So, you know, like this is great, but to me, you know, it's not enough. So take it a step further. I love having the calendar. Another step further, I will have kind of an expense tracker in my daily planner, and each day I'll write out the transactions. So it's a lot of repetitive stuff, but it sticks. And then this printout is from myfrugalhome.com, and I really like this one because she has a checkbox for auto pay. I couldn't find any other ones that also included auto pay. It was usually just, okay, bill, date, amount, and then each of the months. I do have quite a few payments that are auto pay, and I like that I can keep track of it. So I enjoy that printout. And then we go into the sinking funds. So this is great to use as just kind of a reminder, especially if you're new to sinking funds. I am still trying to brainstorm and figure out, you know, what I want to be including. I will definitely be including pets because Maggie has taken me to the vet twice in the past 2 weeks, and you know, she's getting old, so it's okay. But I definitely need to start something for her, as well as dental. So I'll kind of brainstorm for the rest. And then here, she has a printout to keep track of each fund that you contribute to each month. So I have two printouts of that. You could see my, that's a different one. Interesting. Okay, they're a little bit different, but it's a cute. I love that printout. It's really cute. So I printed out a few pages here, then just a little note section. And then we go into health and medical. I'm not going to show you too much of this, but I just have kind of a little divider here, blank page divider here, followed by medical information. So this will be for my husband. And I like having the blank page here so I can just scratch information down, whether it be a doctor, you know, a number for a doctor's office, or if I'm communicating with the insurance company and I just want to make notes, I'm going to have that right in the front, and then we can keep track of all of the visits and such. So I have here, I'm not going to again show you, I have bills that we have been paying, our medical bills, so I keep all of those on hand. And then it goes into my section, same deal, blank sheet of paper, so that way I can have little notes. And then we go into my bills, And then we have Maggie's section here. And I thought I had, where did her page go here? Oh, you know what? It's okay. I gotta flip-flop that one because I wanna have that right behind her note section. So I have Maggie's information in here as well. And I am gonna sit down and fill this out tonight. So everything, I'm gonna just really get in it tonight, and I'm super excited about it. But again, another free printable. It's from thetaylorhouse.com. And I love how detailed this front page is. And I like that this is highlighted because, you know, Maggie's older. She has some skin stuff going on and medication that she's on. So it really just draws your eye to that. And this will be really great for the dog sitters so that they can see, you know, everything at a glance. And then this is going to help so much because I have struggled with keeping up with her health records and her visits. We've had so many visits recently. So I love that, you know, not only does it have the date, but it can be like the age, if anything is, you know, really changing throughout their lifetime. You can really look back on, you know, lab work or the surgeries and remember what age your pet was at when these things occurred. So I really enjoy this setup here. So that concludes the health and medical section. I just have a little bit of Maggie stuff there. Then we go into the cleaning section. This is going to be one of my favorites. I don't know what is wrong with me, but I'm obsessed with at least talking about cleaning organization, and you know, I'm getting into the zone cleaning, and my husband thinks I'm crazy because I think I've had like 5 vacuum cleaners in the past 5 years because they're just not perfect, but I've found the perfect one now. Anyways, off to on a tangent there, or a tangent there. So I have here just a quick write out of my ideal zone cleaning schedule and what I would be doing in each zone of my house. So it's just kind of like a little rough draft for me to glance at. I also have discovered Clean Mama blog, and I am really interested in doing this program here. What she does is very similar to the zones, but instead of going by rooms, she goes by, like, for example, Monday is bathrooms, Tuesday, dust the house, Wednesday, vacuum floors, Thursday, wash floors, Friday, catch all, Saturday, sheets, and Sunday, kind of a rest, or if there's anything you forgot or you couldn't get to, you would get to it that day. So it's a little bit different than what I've been doing, kind of room by room each day. So I'm going to give this a try. And I love that I can write out the month that I'm in and check it off for each week that I complete the sections. So very excited that I found her blog. And I printed up this 30-minute, you know, company quick clean, because who doesn't need that? I think this is so handy. I know this section is going to be piling up for me because I read so many different blogs on, you know, quick tips and tricks and tidying the home and making life easier on yourself, because, hi, work and kids and family take up a lot of time. You don't want to be wasting it on cleaning. And then we go into DIY bathroom cleaners. I really love that she uses a lot of all natural products to create her cleaning solutions. So I have a few recipes for the bathroom. I have for the kitchen. And then I printed up here a 30 minutes a day in a month clutter-free schedule, which I don't know if I'm going to start this in January. Maybe in February, we'll see. But that's going to be pretty fun too. Then we have my home maintenance section. So this is where I'm going to put our vehicle maintenance. So we have 2 cars. So I printed out 2 of these. And this is just great because you can put all of the nitty-gritty information there, because I can never ever remember any of that information, especially VIN number. Who has that memorized? Does anybody have that memorized? If you do, comment down below. I'd be really impressed. This is for both cars. I have two, the vehicle maintenance. Then we have home maintenance. I'm going to print up another one of these too, just so I have a lot of extra room. And I did have on this page my vehicle maintenance print up on here, but I'm not going to use this, so I'm probably just going to put like a note page over it and use that as some like scratch note paper, because I do really like how this is broken down compared to this printable, which is part of the HoosierHomemade.com free packet that I got. So this is included in there. But I just like having a little more detail on this one here. I make sure I kept my contacts in here. So I have two pages of that. And then I have the account information, like passwords and things like that, two pages. And that is in the home maintenance section. We then go into projects, which is empty right now because I had a ton of papers in my binder before I emptied it, because we did a lot of upgrades to our home. I had to dedicate a separate binder for that. So I just need to fill this up with some new project paper, which I'll do at another time. The miscellaneous is the next one. So this is going to be where I keep track of probably like birthday gifts, Christmas gift ideas, TV shows, movies, all of that information, books. I will put that in my miscellaneous section. And we have my notes section, and this is where I will just keep track of any notes and ideas and thoughts that I have. And so I've got a bunch of blank Happy Planner paper in the back here. And then that is the end of it. So I hope you guys enjoyed this, and I hope it gives you maybe some ideas of your own on how you can put together a home management binder and just ease up the information that you have in your everyday planner, if those are things that you keep on hand. I find that I was getting very kind of upset with myself if I had a bunch of information written in my daily planner about, you know, my home tasks, the chores that I wanted to get done, or, you know, anything along the lines of that. If it wasn't checked off, I felt like I was failing. So, but then I would look at my planner and I would see that I actually got a lot done that day. The important stuff was actually getting done. So I figured, you know what, I'm going to try separating it because there is a lot to managing a home and a family. So hopefully, again, this will give you some ideas of your own. And if you did like this video, please give me a thumbs up. And I would love it if you would consider subscribing. And I will talk to you guys again soon in my next one. Bye.